Hello to everyone, this is Lorenzo Piccinali from the Audio Experience Design Team at Imperial College London. Now this is just an example on how perceptual hearing treating could be effective for people using cochlear implants. Cochlear implants are effectively a digital ear which transmit impulses directly to the cochlea, which is the inner part of the ear that then is connected to the neurons that are then connected to the brain. So cochlear implants have a number of channels. Each channel corresponds to a specific frequency band, for example, low frequency, mid frequencies, and high frequencies. Now, early implants had only one channel, early prototypes. Nowadays, we can expect an implant to have 12, 14 working channels. So let's try to hear how cochlear implant users actually hear. So this is an example of how speech sounds on a two-channel cochlear implant. Can you actually guess what the person is saying? And this is a four-channel cochlear implant, so there are four separate channels on four different frequency bands. And again, can you understand what this person is actually saying? I'd say that is still rather difficult, so let's move up and let's try to use eight channels. So can you understand what is being said at the moment? And if you still can't, and actually I confess that I find this difficult as well, let's go to 12 channels. This is a 12 channels cochlear implant. Again, this is what we can expect to achieve in terms of 12 working channels in a modern cochlear implant. Can you understand what this person is saying? It's still rather difficult. So let's try to listen to a 20 channel cochlear implant. And now let's try to listen to the original unprocessed speech signal.
A mouse ran down the hole.
A mouse ran down the hole. So this is actually pretty clear now. So this is what you would hear if you didn't have a hearing loss or a cochlear implant. Now, what is interesting is that now that you know what this person is saying, if you listen back to the degraded versions that we heard before with 2, 4, 8 channels, you can start to make sense of what you're hearing. Of course, training in real life is much more complex. We can't train you to understand every single sentence that might be made. But at the same time, we start understanding how the altered cues that have been modified by the cochlear implant and delivered to our brain can still be understood if we train to listen to what is important and to what is relevant for our task, in this case, speech intelligibility. Now, it is important to consider that these are only simulations. We are only attempting to estimate how a person with cochlear implants might hear. What they're actually hearing might be related to many other factors, subjective factors, and etc. It might be rather different from this.